happening. No gunshots, but they getting.
Hey, what's up you guys, Craft Farms here, and welcome back to MAFM V2. So, I just got everything fired up, I got the combine running again, and everything's started. Why is the Bobcat over there? I don't think I moved it over there. Anyway, we're just getting the truck unloaded here, and then we're going to get going on picking up this straw and selling it, getting some money, because we determined in the last video we don't need any more straw bales at the moment. That can wait until next season, so we are all good there. So then we can just use it and make some extra cash. And we're just picking it up with the forage wagon because it's a whole lot easier and faster than doing it with bales, because we'd have to sit and bale it. Plus we'd also have to buy the net wrap, and then we would have to... Okay, what's this guy doing here? Turn around. Plus then we'd have to get it here, get it loaded in the baler, sit and make all these bales, and then sit and load them up with the truck, and then sell them. That'd be just a pain in the butt. So it's a whole lot faster just to get this forage wagon and just pick it up. It may not be the most American way of doing things, but whatever. And this guy's just being plain old stupid, as he will for these next couple of passes. Because that's how auto combine is. You gotta love it. So we can finish getting this unloaded, and then we'll get the combine unloaded as well. Because he is getting full. I should bring the Cummins out and hook it onto this. That would probably be a little bit better. That tractor's a little bit bigger than this one. It'd probably make a little more sense for this track, for this grain cart, than this tractor does. Oh man, you're not gonna make it. Where are you? Sweetness. Hurry up and turn around. Yeah, that's what we're going to do. We're going to grab the Cummins and put it on this thing, because that would make a whole lot more sense than this little 1570. It's a little more horsepower. We can pull it a little better. That tractor just drives a little bit better, a little bit nicer too, so. Ooh, that was a close one. Oh, come on, 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 come on. Go! Or maybe we'll just use this guy for now, I don't know. Guess we can leave the Cummins sit where it's at. Okay, so now we can move this combine over to the next section. Dismiss the worker, and then he's gonna go like that. So we go like that. Perfect. We'll have him go around a couple of times. Actually, I want that on that side, because we're going to... No, I had it right. So then we gotta take a little bit of a drive here, because I wanna start him down on that corner. Continue kinda where it was before. So we'll just leave that windrow until later, until we start on picking up this side. But yeah, we can get this guy going here and go do some forage wagoning. That sounds weird to say, but but yeah, so we can go pick some stuff up, get going with some stuff. Okay, here we go. Let's get at it. Helps to turn that on first as well. Oh, come on. I always hate that. That's the one thing that I really, really hate about 13. Is that, you know, it's like with 15, a combine won't drive any faster than 6. But like this stuff will just keep going. And then it just, you know, like it likes to unhook or whatever. We're gonna slow way down here just for screenshot purposes. And now we can speed back up. We are gonna have to get some fuel into this monster pretty soon here too, before it runs out. Maybe we'll do that when we go and unload it. That's what we can do. Combine is 61, this is 50 some, grain car is 43, and truck is 24. I don't know how much fuel is left in our fuel trailer, so we'll have to, maybe we'll hook onto it with the pickup and pull it over here, so that way it's in the field, because I have a feeling we'll need it. Because I am quite sure this tractor is not going to be the only thing running low on fuel during this whole process here, this whole harvest. The 1570 is the thing that's probably going to run out the most, because that thing is a bit of a fuel hog. Some of this stuff we'll have to pick up on other passes, which is perfectly alright. Even if we don't get all of it, that really doesn't matter. It'll act as a little bit of fertilizer then. But I mean, there's plenty of straw here. Let's say like one time around, you know, we went around once, that's pretty much filling it. Okay, so let's go get this done. Actually, let's hop over here and get this guy unloaded first. That's a little bit more high priority. Keeping this combine happy and moving. Keep it moving at all costs. Not really, but just keep it moving as much as possible. Oh shoot, I let it go too long. Oh, that was the wrong button. Holy smokes. Major wrong button. This might actually fill this cart too. Yeah, it's gonna fill it. Or we'll just ride with the combine until we're full, because, yeah, here we go. 7% left in the combine anyways, too, so. You know what, I'm actually going to bring the truck down to this, because we're going to be on this end for a while now. No point driving that all the way across the field when the truck's faster. Then we can get that forage wagon unloading, get it refueled up in that tractor. Which I need to see, how are we doing for fueling this? Yeah, this is gonna need fuel pretty soon too. So we'll just pull the full fuel trailer out down over to here and do it that way, because this thing will need fuel here pretty quick. Combine will probably need fuel after a while. No, I guess it's good for a while yet, but it'll need fuel eventually, maybe after the sorghum field or something, or sunflowers, whichever we do next. Not really sure which one I'll do next, I guess, but come on, unload already. Okay, now we can hop back in this. Whoa! It's kind of doing a little bit of a jeez, I forget what that term is. Like when you ride a bicycle and you slam on your front brake and back tire comes off. I know there's a term for it, but I cannot remember the term. Like Healy or something like that? I don't remember. If you know, put it down in the comments. Because I don't remember. I used to know it, but I don't anymore. Is this even making some money? Very little. Oh well, it's something, I guess. I guess it's better than nothing. Oh, that's the button. That's right, we're gonna fill fuel. Yeah, so I mean, we're not making a huge amount of money from it, but we are making something. The startup sound of this truck takes forever. And it's kind of annoying, too. So we'll check and see how much fuel is left in this trailer. We might need to fill it before we can pull it out to the field. Oh, no, we got a pretty good amount yet. Okay, so let's pull this out there. Fill some fuel in that 15. Because it could use a drink. Guess we're only pulling out a couple hundred liters at a time. So let's say this probably holds like close to 10,000 liters, I'm assuming. I don't remember how much it holds now. So that guy's in need of unloading again, of course. So we'll have to catch him here. We'll top off the fuel here after a minute. This guy is high priority, as I said. Gotta get him unloaded, keep him happy. Yeah, can let him turn. Got enough room yet that he can get to this end, turn around. Then we can unload. Just got to make sure that we are right there next to him. It's 97%. Yep. Can easily fill there. I'm not in your way. Back up. We got 10 hours on this tractor already. Kilogram trailer. I think the weight is the same as what's in this thing. Oh, I don't need to be driving with it. We're kind of biting off a lot to chew here, doing all this work, but keeping us busy, I guess, so that's good. I know I turned just way too sharp there, but oh well, I guess. We can drop it down a little bit more here. I think if we go 11, we'll be good. That's plenty fast to be running this forage wagon at. So what's the combines going back along here? We can set it to going up and down. And then he'll have gone around three times. That'll give plenty of room to turn around. Although two really is plenty as well, but usually do three just to be on the safe side. Please miss the truck. Cool. Don't want to ruin our nice truck. I don't like that skipping. Guess I could drop it down a little bit. What happened with this windrow? Oh wait, never mind. I was gonna go pick that windrow up, but I remembered that that's the one that goes over to the other field, so that's the last windrow that we do on this side. What are we at here? 20 minutes. Let's go check on this combine. Okay, so we're going to, oops. We're gonna need to unload it again. We are getting a pretty fair amount of oats. Not as much as I thought we would. This will be trailer load 3, I think. Statistics. Well, we've got 77,525 liters of it. So, I mean, that's not too terrible. It's not quite what I thought it was going to be. I kind of figured, like, it, you know, that it was going to be like what the pre-planted crops were. But it could be that, like, the multi-fruits aren't quite as high yielded as, you know, the standard crops are. I mean, that could very well possibly be. So, never know, I guess. As soon as we get this combine unloaded, we need to switch over to it and set it to go straight up and down. Or, well, not straight, but up and down. Okay, just like that. Perfect. And we can unload this. And this will fill the truck. And we can go unload that. That'll be 3 truckloads, so maybe we'll get maybe like 4 or 5 truckloads out of here. That'd be nice. But we do also have a lot of other crops, so I mean, if we don't get a whole lot of oats, we'll also get all of this other crop, so we'll be pretty well off. I mean, we don't have a lot that we need to buy for equipment, so we can spend a lot more money on land. So this should bring us up over 100,000. 104, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Holy crap, I'm not gonna keep up with that. So 116,288 is what we're at now. So yeah. Maybe another 2 truckloads or something. That'd be pretty dang good. Oat 604, 628. So 628 a liter, 652. That's even better. Dang, we should have put some soybeans in. Of course, because we didn't put it in, there's a great demand for it. That's how it always works. Milk, great demand in 22 hours. Oh, our cows are being productive now again. Finally. Let's close that. Go back to this. And we can go back to picking stuff up. And making a little bit of money. Literally a little bit. I guess we paid a little bit more in fuel, but oh well. Got 4 hours on this tractor already too. Had quite a few hours on the International, I believe. Definitely putting our tractors to work. I mean, of course, in real life, 4 hours is nothing, but in a game, when you think about it, that's a long time. It's a lot of time on a tractor. Oh, that combine's full. Holy smokes. We may have to just save this forage wagon stuff until after harvest is over, because it's full-time job just keeping up with this combine. Please don't fail. Please don't fail. Please don't fail. Hoofda. That was, I think, the closest call to ever having the combine fail and catching it. Wow. I don't know what's up with that. I didn't even look. I was going to look and see if, like, the weight of this trailer is however many liters is in here. I think it is, really. It's at zero when this is at zero, and then... So a liter weighs a kilogram? Uh-oh. Ah, heck with it. We'll just keep following this. We'll follow him until he gets ready to turn around, and then we'll just get that Puma unloaded, and then we'll just keep up with this thing. And of course we can unload the truck right away too, or unload the cart into the truck right away too. Not unload the truck, but unload into the truck right away. Nice empty combine. And a 75%, so yeah. Yep, 14,438 liters and 14,438 kilograms, so. It is just whatever is in there for weight is what there is. So we'll fill this up, and then that'll pretty much be the video once we get the other thing unloaded too. In the next video we should be able to finish off Oats, and then, or very nearly, and then we should be able to start on sunflowers, I think is what we'll do first. Yeah, we'll do the sunflowers first. So I don't know if it's really worth that, having that water trailer, because I'm not seeing anything for water anywhere. I guess when we get in here we can look at this. Yeah, oh, there's water. 3266. Okay. But yeah, so I guess it is kind of worth using the water, and I suppose that's probably why they're 110% instead of just 100. But yeah, guys, that's going to do it for this video. I'm going to go ahead and just shut everything down, let him finish turning around, and then we'll just continue from, whoops, that was the wrong button. I meant to hit H, not Y. But yeah, so we'll just continue from right here in the next video. So thanks for watching, you guys. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to hit that thumbs up button. If you're new to the channel, welcome to the channel. Be sure to subscribe if you like what you see. Be sure to turn on the post notifications to be notified every time I upload a new video. Be sure to check out down below in the description for my PC specs, my upload schedule, as well as links to all of my social medias and some other cool YouTube channels that are worth taking a look at. Thanks for watching, you guys, and as always, we'll see you tomorrow.